everyone, I am here with my final video in the Into the Wild series, and this is the Flamingo inspired eyeshadow. It consists of a really bright white in a corner, some pink, purple, plums, and just, I don't know, really fun girly colours. And I really enjoyed this tutorial, so if you want to find out how to get this look, then just keep watching. Okay, as you can already see, I've done this eye. So to save time on this one, I already applied my primer and a white cream color base, so you can go ahead and do that before you start, and then take any matte white eyeshadow or shimmery if you prefer, and just take any fluffy brush that looks like this, dip into the color and sort of try to make the lid white and go just above the lid as well, but don't go all the way up to the brow bone. You can go all the way up to the brow bone with your cream color base. So that's just going to help the colours be a bit more vibrant. The next thing you're going to want to do is take a pinky orangey eyeshadow. So I don't have a pinky orangey, so I'm going to mix some from my palette, two pinks and an orange, to create the one that I want. But if you have a pinky orange, just go for it. So take some of that onto like a sort of dense blending brush and just pat it into your outer corner. You can see this isn't completely like hot pink. I don't know, maybe it looks hot pink in the camera. But it's like a pinky orange. It has like an orange undertone to it. Kind of bring that in. You want this to be kind of dramatic too. So I'm going to bring it up here. And kind of out also. Don't look at me like I'm crazy. This is what I did for this one. You've got all that pink on your eye and you look retarded. Hold on. Take a puffy blending brush again and sort of blend it out. Okay, so now that you have this really bright pop of pink in your eye, you're going to take like a sort of angled brush. I'm taking this brush, it's just a miniature Bobbi Brown eyebrow brush, but I'm going to use it for my shadow. And take any black eyeshadow of your choice and just sort of work it into the outer corner. So, just really pack that into the outer corner. And it's going to create the like flamingo beak. Yeah. I'm a bit lame. Why did I just say lame? So now that we have this black on our outer corner, we're gonna take a small blending brush like this one. So it's sort of like a miniature version of this pink one that we used. And I'm going to take a deep purple color. And I'm gonna blend that on top of the black. So it's gonna diffuse that black a little bit, and it's going to make it look a bit more purple, so I'm going to take it onto that. Really concentrating on the outer corner there. And tap a bit off. And then you can kind of bring it in also. So you can see it's very concentrated on that outer corner. And then it sort of comes in lighter. Then you tap a little bit off the pink that you have and just use whatever's remaining. And just kind of blend out that color. Okay, so now just take any sort of flat brush and take a lighter pink color, so any like baby sort of pink of your choice, and put it right underneath where you've blended that purple. This is just gonna kind of reintroduce that lighter color to your lid, because you probably lost some of it when you were blending. Well, I did. There we go. So this is the eyeshadow so far, and you're going to want to redefine your inner corner also, because you really want it to be have a nice pop of light in there. So go back in with your jumbo pencil, blend it out, and then reapply your eyeshadow. Okay, so the next thing I'm going to do now is I'm going to take this Dior, color designer 5-piece thing, and this is in pink design. And I'm gonna take that beautiful shimmery baby pink at the top, and I'm gonna use this. It's actually a little bit sheer, but it's very shimmery. You see the shimmer more than you see the color, actually. But I'm just gonna use that right on my brow bone. And you probably won't see it in the camera, but hopefully when I put the pictures up, you'll be able to see a bit better. It really just brings the whole look together with the shimmer. Okay, so now that's it for the eyeshadow. And in the same little palette, I have a, believe it or not, that is a plum. It's not a black, it's like a plummy cream eyeshadow. So I'm just going to take a little angled brush. I'm going to apply that to my top and bottom lash line. Just a point, when you're doing your bottom lash line, okay, I flicked my top lash line up and I want to do the same, so I want to make it parallel, but I don't want them to meet. So creating like a double wink, basically. It's very subtle. And I did on this one too, this one's actually a bit more obvious. I can never get them to exactly match how we did that. Then the last step is just take a, I'm just taking the little applicator that came with the palette and take that beautiful shimmery purple at the top. And then just use that to diffuse that color on the bottom. That plummy color. And that's kind of going to smoke it out. So I'm going to go ahead and do the rest of my face and I'll be back to show you the finished look. Okay guys, so here is the finished eyeshadow look, and I just added my mascara and I put on a blush, just a pinky blush from MAC, which is Pinch Me, and my lipstick is like a baby pink, which is called Hug Me. Pinch Me, Hug Me. So yeah, this is the end of the Into the Wild series. I will be starting some new videos. I have a lot of videos lined up, guys, and I actually have 2 requests, so they're at the top of the list, so I'll try to get to those as soon as I can. Yeah, but please be patient with me if I don't get them out really, really soon, because I do have exams at the moment, so just letting you know. But anyway, I will see you soon, hopefully, and take care. I'll talk to you later. Bye.